I know Outlander fans have been waiting for this release for a while now, and it marks the first release of the actress that plays Claire Frazier on the autograph checklist. So that would be the big, big hit. And in typical Cryptozoic fashion, we've got 24 packs, 5 cards per pack, a memorabilia, excuse me, a wardrobe card, and an autograph in every box, as well as a ton of great chase insert sets and beautiful base cards from Episodic Images. When I said very cool inserts, check out this one. Character cards, kind of in this black and white sepia. This one of Jamie. On set is another. Ooh, look. I didn't see this on the checklist. Canvas Parallels. I don't know if you can see the texturing there. It might be hard to pick up, but if you can compare it to this card.
Something really fun about these cards, like I'm looking at the characters chase cards. Oh, that's what you showed a minute ago of Jamie, huh?
Yes.
Sorry, I've got multiple monitors going on.
It's okay, bro. I understand. Listen, I don't know how you do it, to be honest with you.
Yeah, all you got to do is just open the cards and look at them. I got to talk to our friends. I got to look at sell sheets. I got to do all this. So there's some really interesting stuff in this that's so unique. So first off, I need to mention, like Luka Doncic to his sponsors, GoGTS.net is the place to get all of your information on cards, trading card news, hobby news. But Cryptozoic steps up their game with their sell sheets now, and they're starting to put in so much more unique content. You know, they were really pretty simple for a couple of early years, you know, but with great autographs. Well, now, not only are we getting the 1 in 3 on-set chase cards, 1 in 3 character chase cards, 1 in 3 Skyboat song, which is a nice little, throw in there for the fans of the show. But 1 in 96 packs, there's a chase card that's not a sketch, not an autograph. There's a Malcolm folding card. Now, I don't know what Malcolm means. Maybe that's somebody in the show. But those are only 1 in 96 packs.
Here's so a Malcolm. There's the Malcolm guy.
Oh, okay.
Are Canvas Parallels on the sell sheet? Because I don't think they were. So I love the fact that they're also doing Easter eggs. And it's not just the base cards, because this is one, too, for the character set has a Canvas Parallel.
So they actually are. So this is where it's getting tricky and cool with them. So one autograph per box, a 1 in 24 packs. They don't give odds on dual autograph cards, but they do give odds on dual and triple wardrobe cards. So the wardrobe cards are also 1 in 24 packs, but dual and triples are only 1 in 275 packs. And if this sounds boring to you watching, this company just keeps adding more and more information, which is great because, like I said, their earlier sets were really just focused on the product and they're really starting to mix it up. So I'm getting extra excited. The sketch cards are 1 in 288 packs. So if you get one of those as your hits, they're actually exceedingly rare. Is that one per case? I got to look at the exact numbers here.
Wow. Now
boxes, 24
packs. Here's something else I don't always remember. We've seen foil parallels stamped for their products before.
That's right where I'm getting.
But check this out. This red one, not only is it stamped with red, but it also is serial numbered.
To just 50, if I'm reading this sell sheet right.
Correct. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah. So the parallels, the variants that they've added, well, I don't know if they're going to do canvas stock for every product, but what I was trying to say at the very beginning, and I got distracted by these numbers, is those character cards are so well designed with the Outlander theme, you know, the Outlander age. It looks like the kinds of things you would see in a British book from the mid-1800s.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So I wonder if the canvas stock choice for a variant is somewhat because of the fact that it's Outlander or just something that they're trying. But those are 1 in 3 packs.
I love the puzzle cards. Look at that.
Those are fun. You can see the entire puzzle if you go to gogts.net.
Go ahead.
What you pulled was a red Fraser seal foil stamp, which are 1 in 30 packs.
Oh, so,
like, that's rarer than one per box.
I love it.
And they actually have that variant of base, characters inserts, onset inserts, and the Skyboat song inserts.
So you can find these? Oh, these are quotes. Okay. All that was good, all that was fair, all that was me is gone. Deep.
Where's that? Is that on the back of the cards? Or?
No, that's the front of the card.
Oh, was that one of the Skyboat song cards, maybe? I'm on the...
Yes, the Skyboat song.
The feed I'm watching is on delay. So.
It's called... it's numbered Q4, so I called it quotes, but yes, the Skyboat song. And we know that because that is written on the back right there.
Yeah. And then finally, printing plates are 1 in 256 packs. Now, the total chance of finding a special insert between the printing plates, the Malcolm folding box, and all of that is approximately 2 in 24 packs. But there are no guaranteed number of special inserts per box. So, just a little legalese there that they're not saying that you will get. They're saying you should get 2 hits per box. And there are 6 convention exclusives.
Ooh, fun.
Yeah. Now, they don't say which convention they're going to go to, though, for those. So,
anyways. I have the list. I can't share it, though.
Let's watch Ivan read sell sheets. It's really fun. It's got pictures. Like, they did a good, like, I don't get to see all the sell sheets, but I'm guessing that if they all looked like Cryptozoic, you'd be much happier, Rob.
Yeah. They've,
even GTS's competitors would be much, like, just anybody that's trying to inform people about this product. These great job, Cryptozoic, on the sell sheets.
And we have a authentic wardrobe card of John Bell as young Ian Murray, numbered to just 99.
Ooh.
So we'll give that away, hopefully, to an Outlander fan.
Who isn't an Outlander fan? Come on now. That's all I got to say about that. Actually, I'm not. I've wanted to watch the show, but I have not had Stars, and it has not creeped its way onto Netflix that I know of.
Another canvas parallel.
I have a pretty good friend who's one of the producers on the show.
Really?
Yeah.
There's a character card of Brianna. Another canvas parallel. Great photography. And we've got an autograph card of Sophie Skelton as Brianna Randall Fraser. Look at that signature. Wow.
Wow. That is a good signature.
Yeah, it is. Of a popular character, too. So,
what's her name? Sophie?
Skelton.
Skelton. Cool.
Sophie Skelton.
Seems like as good a time as any to remind people that the future Duchess of York actually has autographs in an entertainment product from a few years ago. So don't sleep on these. You never know. Entertainment careers last a lot longer than football careers or baseball careers. Imagine 50 years from now, Sophie Skelton winning an Oscar and you got her autograph card in this product.
Yeah, no doubt. Here's one of the gold foil, not numbered, parallels.
Awesome. So those are 1 in 8, so we should see 2 or 3 of those, hopefully. And if this is your first time ever tuning into the show, just so you know, we do give away the hits. So make sure you follow us not only wherever you're watching, but follow us on Twitter, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. That's where we'll have the entries for the hits. And we need you to enter there no matter where you're watching the show, just to help us aggregate the winners. Also, if you want a chance at that Cupid arrow tip relic from an actual episode of Arrow on the CW from Cryptozoic, make sure that you retweet our pinned tweet that has the Periscope broadcast going on. Retweet that pinned tweet and be following us to enter to win.
Special thank you to BadBrad87 for subscribing on Twitch. Very much appreciated. This past week, we did an exclusive box break of 2019 Top Series 1 Baseball and gave away the hit from that box, as well as another winner won all the parallels and inserts, and then somebody else won all the base cards. So their subscribers have their benefits. Might do another one next week with a box break of Garbage Pail Kids. We love the 90s, if anybody would be interested. I would do that. Another gold parallel. And just looks like a couple packs left. Beautiful. Oh, speaking of Sophie Skelton, there she is.
Very cool. She's on Twitter as well, at Skelton Sophie.
There's a great onset card, the HMS Porpoise. Another onset, but this is a canvas parallel. Mary of Soul, she sailed on a day over the sea to sky. Such fancy talk.
Yeah, that's what really brings you in with this show from everything I've heard is they get you, man. They go for it. They commit.
Well, I mean, the writers have to be pretty well versed in that degree of culture to be able to do that, you know? It's amazing.
So it's from the creator of Battlestar Galactica.
Is it really? Yeah. Wow.
But essentially, it's also based on a set of novels that are where the story itself comes from. And sorry, I'm trying to compose a tweet while I'm thinking. Never a good idea for Ivan to do two things at once. But yeah, so the creator of Battlestar Galactica got pitched the show, and a couple of his, so like I mentioned, my friend was an associate producer on that show, was a couple of them were already fans of the novels. Like they'd read the novels inside, and then they got pitched the show, and they said, oh, so they went to the producer, the head producer, and they got the big guy on board. But essentially, he kind of gives them, you know, he oversees it, but he's like, hey, you guys go and you know this stuff. So
very cool.
So it's cool. Right. It actually is somewhat fanboys that are making it. Fanboys is not the right term because they're not all boys, but fans, true fans,
super fans.
Yep.